Yeah, toss me a coin or I'm not doing it.
Ew! A witcher has two main tools, a steel sword for men and a silver sword for monsters. But why silver? Let's get technical. Humans have craved and crafted silver since before there were history books to record its widespread use. We've long used the precious metal for decoration, ornamentation, and money, probably because, like copper and gold, you can easily find silver in its elemental form. The 47th element on the periodic table has also made its way into human myth and legend, often associated with purity, holiness, and the gods themselves. This association with purity is also probably why silver in our stories interacts aggressively with monsters like werewolves. But in a witcher's hands, could there be some science here too? Well, let's find out.
Come on, Roach, this way. No, not that way.
First, we know that the success of a silver sword will not be due to the sword itself. Elemental silver has many interesting properties. For instance, it conducts both heat and electricity better than any other metal. It's also the most reflective. However, elemental silver is also extremely soft and malleable. In terms of strength, silver has an ultimate tensile strength less than that of human hair. So if you were to make a silver sword out of pure silver, Geralt would probably just destroy it upon his first monster encounter, and being the superhuman that he is, he could probably bend a sword like this all by himself. At least Witcher canon does state that silver swords are not pure silver, they are steel swords coated with silver. So whatever this sword is supposed to be doing, it can't be because of the sword, it has to be because of the metal itself. All the way back in ancient Greece, and probably sooner, humans noticed something curious about food and water in the proximity of silver. When perishable food items were placed in something like a silver-lined barrel, those items would stay fresher for longer. In the 1800s, when people regularly rode their roaches around, American settlers were exploring the Wild West, and as they did so, they were known to drop a silver dollar into their canteens to keep their water from getting scummy too quickly. Now, there's no magic going on here. Silver really does have an effect on life and is in fact dangerous to certain organisms. Oh, I hate portals. Silver and many metals have an oligodynamic effect. That is, they act as a biocide and are lethal to life at low concentrations. But not all life. Have you ever wondered why something like silverware, a silver spoon, never really gets gross, while something like a wooden spoon in the same conditions can definitely get gross? Like if you left it in the dishwasher too long and it was still wet and you never took it out and put it away like your girlfriend said, so it got mold all over it? This effect is why silver acts to kill many bacteria and microorganisms. To know exactly why, though, we have to get technical. Come on, Roach, what? Yeah, he is distractingly handsome in the show. Yeah, I know, I'm supposed to be like watching Geralt, but all I can think is like... If we can understand why silver is lethal to certain microbial monsters, we might be able to extend that reasoning out to a witcher's world. It's like Scooby-Doo cartoons. Oh. What is specifically special about silver is how silver ions, silver atoms missing an electron from their outer shell, interact with microorganisms, and they attack those organisms in four main ways. When silver ions encounter a bacterial cell, they mess up just about everything that bacterial cell needs to do to continue to live. The first thing these silver particles will do is stick themselves or adhere to the cell membrane. This causes the cell membrane to warp and fold in unnatural ways, which can change its permeability, what can go in and what can go out easily, and causes cell gut leakage. It's very witchery. Silver ions also slice their way into the cell itself, destabilizing proteins and ribosomes and disrupting mitochondria, the powerhouse of the cell. This buildup of silver material inside of a cell is also just straight up toxic, which causes widespread cell damage. Lastly, and more broadly, as silver infiltrates these cells, it changes or modulates the basic function of cell signaling, leading to chaos and eventual cell death. Now, claiming the tiny microscopic bounties on these cells may not sound like much, but silver, in the right application, can make a huge difference. Oh, it tastes like a drowner's butt. Because of its properties, silver was one of the first antibiotics before pharmaceuticals and has been used in some form for healing since Hippocrates. You know, the guy who coined a doctor's Hippocratic oath? Today, silver is still used in healing, from burn creams to bandages to silver-based sutures. After all this time, silver is still useful in our fight against some legitimately scary monsters. Even now, it's being used to fight antibiotic-resistant bacteria like MRSA. And if it can do that, wind's howling. Sorry, I gotta say it once in a while. But how could an element that helps with healing be a Witcher's signature weapon? No, no, no sing. As I've said before, I love The Witcher in Henry Cavill's jawline because although it is fantasy, there are rules, laws, and explanations for everything happening. Different monster biology requires different fighting tactics. What I'm suggesting is that in the Witcherverse, monsters have a specific biology such that silver acts as a monster side. Imagine that monsters in the Witcherverse have cells with similar enzymes and proteins and organelles that a microbe like E. coli has. Then a strike from a silver sword may not just cut like it would do to human cells. Shut up, it might end up dealing a far deadlier blow. And though Geralt could put something like a silver-based oil on his sword to potentially enhance any effect, mixtures like this have been used forever, he might not even have to. When silver sits around in the presence of oxygen, it reacts with it to produce silver oxide. It's kind of like silver rust. And this silver oxide is a main component in many of the compounds and mixtures that we've been talking about. And this naturally produced silver residue is critical because Witcher lore states that it is the silver sword itself and not some oil or other mixture that makes this weapon dangerous to monsters. This helps explain why silver swords are dangerous in The Witcher. What? Yeah, no, I thought the show was pretty good. You're telling me. So, how does a Witcher's silver sword actually work? Well, I think in a Witcher's world, the same silver that can help heal human wounds hurts monsters as metal ions dangerously interact with their biology and alter their metabolism. If silver in our world can help us fight monsters like MRSA, maybe Geralt can fight fictional beasts in the same way. Because science. Earned that one. Coin is good for me. The same reasoning that we used in this episode would also naturally extend to other monsters and myths, like non-Witcher werewolves and silver bullets. If werewolves had the same kind of biology that we were talking about, then a silver bullet would damage them. However, I would rather be shot by a silver bullet than a normal bullet because of the antimicrobial properties surrounding silver. So, silver bullets less effective against people, more effective potentially against werewolves. So,